Good morning, students. Now, I hope that you will be well and healthy at home and doing your work regularly. So far, we have discussed about determinants and its properties. Now, I am taking some questions from the exercise on determinants. That is, as we have discussed 1, 2, 3 questions. Now I am taking question number 6. That is, you have to find the value of this determinant is 0. If we directly calculate by the method of finding the value of order 3, we get it 0. But it is written that you have to find the value using properties. So you may use one or two properties and then you can find the result also. But in this case, here all diagonal elements are 0, and if we take this as a matrix, so and transpose it. Suppose this is a matrix A and we are transposing it, we get it is after transposition equal to minus A. So this is a skew symmetric matrix because A transpose is minus A in this case, and we know that if a skew symmetry matrix is there, its diagonal elements are 0. So we have A transpose is equal to minus A here. Now take the determinant value both sides. Determinant A transpose will be equal to determinant minus A. Now we have a property in determinants that determinants Ka is equal to k power n into determinant A, where n is the order of determinant. Here we are having order 3 determinant. So this implies A power determinant A power A transpose is equal to minus 1 power 3, as minus A means minus 1 is the constant and order is 3. So minus 1 power 3 into determinant A, and minus 1 power 3 is minus A. So we get determinant A transpose is equal to minus A determinant. This is obtained from above, but we know that transpose of A is also equal to determinant of transpose of A is equal to determinant A by the property number 1. It means we are having two values of A transpose. One is A determinant A transpose is equal to minus determinant A, and another by the property determinant A transpose is equal to determinant A. So equating both from right side, you get determinant A is equal to minus determinant A. Taking one side, we get 2 determinant A is equal to 0. So determinant A is equal to 0. It is the result right hand side. But this is one property of skew symmetric matrix also. The determinant value of skew symmetric matrix is 0. Now we can take another example question from exercise, that is question number 8. Having elements 1a a square, 1b b square, 1c c square, and you have to prove is equal to a minus 1 into b minus c into c minus a. We take left hand side, and our method will be using the property and making maximum zero in the question. So we fix R1 and apply R2 becomes R2 minus R1 and R3 becomes R3 minus R1, as we can make zero in place of one. So we apply R2 becomes R2 minus R1, so change will be on R2, that is equal to 1 minus 1, that is 0, b minus a, and that b square minus a square. Similarly, R3 becomes 1 minus 1, 0, c minus a, and c square minus a square. Now, we factorize the term in R2 and R3. And from R2, we take common b minus a. So, from R2 you are taking b minus a, it means there remain 0, 1 and b plus a. And from R3, you take common c minus a. So, it becomes 0, 1, c plus a. Now, we are having maximum zeros, so we calculate this easily. It becomes, here in right hand side is a minus b, but we get b minus a. So take minus 1 common, it becomes a minus b into c minus a, and the value of determinant 1 into c plus a minus b plus a, b plus a. This is misprint. Minus 0 plus 0. We are obtaining the value of determinant along column 1. Thus we get minus 1 into b into a minus b c minus a into 1 into c minus b, as a and minus a cancel out. Again, in right hand side there is b minus c also. Here is c minus a, so take common minus 1 again. We get minus 1 square a minus b, b minus c, c minus a, and minus 1 square is equal to plus 1. So we get a minus b, b plus b minus c, c minus a, that is RHS. So it is proved. Now there is question number 10, in which a determinant is given and is equal to, you have to find 5x plus 4 into 4 minus x square. Here we see that from right hand side 5x plus 4 is obtained by, if we add in R1, R2 plus R3. So applying R1 becomes R1 plus R2 plus R3. We get 5x plus 4, 5x plus 4, 5x plus 4, the element of R1. You will add correspondingly x plus 4 plus 2x plus 2x, that is 5x plus 4, 2x plus x plus 4 plus 2x, that is again 5x plus 4, 2x plus 2x plus 5, x plus 4, you get again 5x plus 4. Now in R1, 5x plus 4 is the element common, so we take it common outside. So it becomes 5x plus 4, determinant 1, 1, 1, and 2x, x plus 4, 2x, 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 x plus 4, R2 and R3 remain same. Now, how will you make maximum zeros? You will fix column 1 and from column 2 subtract column 1, and again from column 3 subtract column 1. So applying C2 becomes C2 minus C1. What happens? 5x plus 4 and C1 remains as it is, 1, 2x, 2x. Now column 2 will change, 1 minus 1, that is 0, x plus 4 minus 2x, that is 4 minus x, 2x minus 2x, that become 0. And now again apply in column 3. Column 3 becomes C3 minus C1. So 1 minus 1 you get 0, 2x minus 2x get 0, and x plus 4 minus 2x, that is again 4 minus x. Now we get maximum 0, so we calculate the determinant 5x plus 4 into 1 into 4x in 4 minus x into 4 minus x, 4 minus x square minus 0 plus 0. Thus we get 5x plus 4 into 4 minus x whole square, that is the right hand side, so it is proved. Now there is another question, question number 12. 1 x x square x square 1 x x x square 1. You have to prove this is equal to 1 minus x cube whole square. Apply R1 becomes R1 plus R2 plus R3. Here R3 is also R1 becomes R1 plus R2 plus R3. That is 1 plus x plus x square, 1 plus x plus x square, 1 plus x plus x square. And R2 and R3 remain same. X square 1 x x x square 1. Now 1 plus x square take common, we get 1 1 1 in R1 and x square 1 x in R2 and x x square 1 in R3. Now for making maximum 0, we will fix C1 and C2 will change C2 minus C1 and C3 will also change C3 minus C1. So subtracting correspondingly C1 element from C2 elements, we get 0, 1 minus x square minus 1, and again subtracting C1 element correspondingly from C3 element, so this becomes 0, x minus x square, 1 minus x. Now factorize the elements of C2 and C3 and take common 1 minus x from C2 and 1 minus x from C3. We get 1 plus x square into 1 minus x into 1 minus x, and this become 1 0 0 x square 1 plus x x x minus x 1. Now we have maximum zeros, so we calculate this determinant 1 plus x square 1 minus x into the value of determinant is obtained by the calculation method of determinant of order 3. So we get 1 plus x square minus 0 plus 0. Thus we get after calculation 1 plus x square 1 minus x. This is 1 minus x cube. If we multiply these two, this is the expanded factors of 1 minus x cube. Again we get 1 minus x, 1 plus x square. These two are also the factor of 1 minus x cube. So we get 1 minus x cube into 1 minus x cube, that is 1 minus x cube power 2, which is a right hand side. Now practice all questions from exercise 4.2, question 2, question 4, question 7, question 8, question 9. Using the properties, recall the properties and use the operation to make according to right hand side. And use the steps to make the maximum zeros, then find the value of determinant. This is the method. Now, students, you are given a online test of second chapter inverse trigonometric function in MCQ form. You have to solve that and send me the your solutions screenshot. It is compulsory for all students. That is the checking of your study and your understanding the chapter you are given. So there are some different forms of writings in the questions, as there is written sine, arc sine. Arc sine means sine inverse. And somewhere it is written cos k minus 1 x. It means cos inverse x. So we resemble these all to your textbook and then solve them accordingly. If there is some difficulty, you can ask me, but first send your responses and through your email. It will be sent to check your knowledge from JEET also, and all students of KVs are solving MCQ in this manner, and sending. So do accordingly, don't take it lightly. Do your work perfectly. If there is some difficulty, you may ask me on my personal WhatsApp number. You can send your answers screenshot on my personal WhatsApp number. It is must, so do accordingly. Thank you. Have a nice day.